Yo, 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 what's happening, everybody? Welcome back once again. I know that was a little presumptuous, but I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. And what do? I teach the world accounting by the basics, building block by building block by building block. Now, before we get into this special episode of the classic series, episode 51, accounting for beginners number 51, AFB number 51, we're going to talk about payroll. We're going to talk about payroll for this one, and maybe the next couple videos we're going to do payroll. We're going to switch gears. We're going to switch up them gears. Don't stop doing donuts. Nothing gonna change when the police show up. Burning rubber in the streets. We're just going to go payroll. The 50 is going to be payroll. Anyway, look up here. This is the best, bar none, playlist in the world. It happens to be an accounting playlist, and it'll make all your dreams come true, whatever they are. So just hit play right here. Thank you very much. I was thinking, what could I do now? What account after the big 50 celebration, right? Now, what do I do now? I was trying to, I want to get 50. Well, I think I'll go to payroll. I haven't touched on payroll. I know I have gotten a couple questions. If I could touch on payroll, some payroll caveats. This one is a weekly paycheck. Weekly paycheck, weekly employee paycheck. Jump cut back in. Boy! In any of these accounting problems that I do, I think you have to put a hat on. Put your hat on. Meaning, like, are you the employer? Are you the employee? Are you both? And in these circumstances, and you're the employee. Put your employee hat on. So I wanted to start with this one for payroll because I think a lot of people have gotten a paycheck before with taxes taken out, and that would be payroll. Now, a lot of people I hear say, I ran payroll. Well, they just wrote a check from their business account to themselves. That's not payroll. What is that? Draw. It's a draw. Our shareholder distribution. It's not payroll. It's not payroll, in my opinion, unless you have taxes taken out. So I didn't want to make this one too long or too dicey or too much. Another caveat I did want to make about the payroll is that, I've gotten paychecks before. A job I had for a few years, worked under a CPA. I actually did payroll manually. I did the payroll and I did that for a year. And so I know what payroll is about for a company. So I did it for probably, I think, 6 or 7 companies. I used to cut checks every week for some people. I was real free. I used to have a stack of checks, like 80 checks, that would come up to like $30,000. I'd be like, I'd smell the checks and stuff. I just print them on my printer off QuickBooks. And now when I started my business 2 years ago, that was some of my very first clients. I do their payroll for them. And so the payroll, I think, is like a real life. I teach the basics, but these payrolls are going to be real life. Whether you have a payroll question in one of your classes, that's good. You will have some of those, but I think this is more for real life. But anyways, if you know payroll and it doesn't change, which is good, like someone says, I'm paying so-and-so $400 this week in payroll. Great. I can do that. Like, you go do your things and that's fine. Then, conversely, non-payroll, you have a person that says, I have to make more expenses. What? No, what? That's no. It's always like an argument of it's an expense for the business or not, Anyways, let's get going on this one. That's I was trying to tell you that if you can master the payroll, you can get some clientele when you don't have that much experience, because you don't need much experience to do the payroll. I think you just have to be very precise, and no one wants to learn this that they own their own business. So this is a great skill to have, in my opinion. Currently, I have 8 clients that I do payroll for, varying degrees, mostly weeklies, and I run through a company called Gusto. So I pay Gusto a little cut, and they do all, I just tell them, oh, run this amount. So they get a little cut of it, and then the client gives me, more than I give Gusto, and I make some money for running payroll, which is basically the start of this. Now this is, I talk so much, I'm sorry. This is the 5 minutes now, people, that we're just gonna start talking payroll, all right? Let's get this in. We're trying to better ourselves. Let's do this. Let's better ourselves. Come on, getting juicy over here. Let's go. Okay, 51 here. We're doing payroll. We're doing a weekly paycheck. We're wearing our employee hat, so we're an employee. We're just a regular Joe, regular Jane, Main Street Joe, Main Street Jane. Getting up, working hard, putting in 40 hours a week at $10 an hour. I think that's, well, I'm 2017. Yeah, I guess, that's a job. So then what are you doing? What happens with that? Think with me. Don't be like, what's going on? Think with me, What happens when you get that? You get $400, so you get a check for $400? No, I wish. With taxes taken out, how does that work? Because 40 hours times $10 an hour is $400. You're gonna have $400. That's gonna be your gross wages. And coincidentally, these gross wages is what's reported on your tax return. Yeah, not your net pay down here. We'll get to that. When you run payroll, every time they're gonna take out 6.2% of the $400. 6.2% of $400 for Social Security. Alright? Out of every $400, every paycheck. So that's gonna be, and you guys have gotten paychecks before, right? Somebody's paid taxes in this world. So that's coming out of the $400. Also coming out of the $400 is 1.45% of Medicare tax. That comes out to $5.8. All right. Now these two are Social Security and Medicare. 6.2 plus 1.45 is 7.65% of your money's coming out in taxes. That's off rip. There are some limitations, but for our purpose here, that's off rip, okay? Every week you work $400, they're taking out, this is like $30, they're taking $30 out of your $400 off rip. You're not getting that back, you're not getting a refund off that. When you turn 65 or whatever, you get that later. So they're taking that off rip, okay? So I need there to be a distinction between, because this is happening every time you run a paycheck with this federal government here in the U.S. We try to do our best. Let's go. I just took this at random. This does not have to be the federal withholdings of 44.4. I just put that number in to make a nice net pay. This could be zero. You could pay more. We will get into what happens to this at the end of the year. But this depends. Like in the United States, you fill out a W-4 form when you are hired at a job, and they ask you, oh, like how many exemptions do you want? Are you married? Because they're trying to figure out, what they're trying to do with those questions is they're trying to figure out how much to take out of your federal withholding, so they'll take out a little bit too much and you'll get a refund at the end of the year and you'll think that's great when it's just your money. But this is a paycheck, this is a payroll. You start out with gross $400 minus Social Security of 24.80 minus from your $400 $1.45 of Medicare tax. Now this is 7.65, that happens for every single dollar you make, all right? The government's taking 7 cents out of that, all right? Every $100 of chippers you make, they're taking $7.65 out of that $100. $7.65 out of the $100. Okay. And it's been determined, or you want to, or I've done it. They take out $44.40 a week of federal withholdings, and this gets added up every week. So at the end of the year, it's times 52. If you put $44.40 in every week for federal withholdings, this accumulates on your tax return at the end of the year, your personal tax return, your 1040. Leaving you with 325. See how it was 400? This is what you have to tell the IRS at the end of the year. You made 400, but you really only took home 325, and you get a chance to get 40 of that back, and 30 of it's gone. Thanks for playing. Anyways, this is net pay. This 325. Look, the 400 is gross wages, okay? The 325 is a net pay, or you could call the 325 your take-home pay, or you could call the 325 your chippers, you're getting your chippers up, okay? Or you could call the 325 your check. What's a check? Yeah, right? Or you could call your 325 a direct deposit. But anywho. And what happened to that $75? Is my employer keeping that? Does he get to keep that? I don't know. What do you think happens to the... See, that's how much you make. That's how much you're reporting to make. You have to report you make this. You know, you just work for your boss. Some dude's your boss, and then he says, I'll pay you $10 an hour. You say, great, it's $400. Then he gives you a check at the end of the week for $325. You're like, where's that $75, chief? He's like, oh, taxes. You're like, oh, okay. So, okay. Until next time, man. This one's fun, right? $75. What happened to $75? Did your boss keep it? Is your boss getting some margaritas with his girlfriend? Is he getting a little Applebee's 2 for $20 for like 3 days that week? Anyways, my shit's about, ooh. Anyways, my camera's about to die. I love doing these accounting for beginners. Thanks for your support. If you've watched it this long, give it a like, share, comment, subscribe, do all the stuff. And I'll see you next time. Deuces.